Your story begins in the middle of a devastating battle on the lawless seas. After a brutal defeat, you and other survivors find yourselves shipwrecked on a remote and perilous island. Here, you'll choose your captain and begin your new life of piracy with your first mate, Asna.
The wind favors the fearless. Let us chase it.
She will use her extensive seafaring experience and knowledge of the Indian Ocean to guide you in your quest for riches and infamy. In Skull and Bones, increasing your infamy is an ongoing objective that you'll pursue. Infamy is the center of player progression. The more infamous you become, the more opportunities open up across the world, allowing you to build more impressive ships, to take on riskier contracts, and to gain untold riches as you ascend the pirate ranks. After escaping the shipwreck, you'll approach the Red Isle and discover the pirate den of St. Anne, which offers up a first taste of pirate culture.
Another bottom feeder washes ashore.
In St. Anne, you'll find vendors such as the blacksmith, refiner, and more. By speaking to the shipwright, you'll be tasked with gathering the materials to build your first pirate vessel, the Bedar.
I can build you the mightiest ship in the Indian Ocean, but how you steer it into the waves is up to you, Captain.
All ships in Skull and Bones have unique perks and a wealth of customization options to suit different playstyles. Weapons like the long gun excel at sniping enemy weak points from a distance, while demi-cannons act like ship-mounted shotguns. Likewise, armor has different elemental damage defenses, from flooding to fire, explosive, and tearing resistance. Higher tier armor will even grant you perks. The furniture you choose for your ships also offer a range of effects, including increased stamina regeneration for your crew and quicker reload times. Your ships are the heart of your adventure, and to compete for supremacy of the ocean, you must expand your fleet for the many challenges ahead. With your Bedar crafted and customized, it's time to set sail.
Let the wind help us sail!
Out in open waters, you'll come face to face with Skull and Bones' most visceral gameplay element, naval battles. Throughout the Indian Ocean, you'll encounter other players battling, exploring, and pursuing their own objectives. All contracts you take on can be progressed both in solo and in co-op. And if you find yourself facing overwhelming odds, you can fire a signal to rally nearby pirates to your cause, bringing players together to increase your chances of success. While your early contracts will have you tracking and attacking gatherer ships, at any time, you can plot your own course, whether to investigate mysteries or to test your mettle against other hostile faction ships. Whoever your enemy may be, the first thing you should do is identify their ship rank and loadout with your spyglass. Pirates don't play fair, and you should use whatever intel you have to your advantage. Choose the right combination of ship and customization for each challenge, which will help you navigate this hell in paradise. Beyond being an ocean of danger, the high seas are also full of possibility. You'll discover wrecks that can be salvaged for silver and other resources, and encounter dynamic events like wealthy merchant convoys with powerful warship escorts.
Big work! Fire!
Back on land, keep your ears open for tall tales of ghastly glows and terrors from the deep, and seek out these legends in pursuit of infamy and rare loot. The choice of risk versus reward is yours to take. If you want to test your mettle against other players, seek out treasure maps.
A treasure map! Luck is with us!
Finding one will automatically trigger PvP and mark your location, allowing others to hunt you down. Outwit your opponents and earn legendary troves of loot, all for yourself.
Can you see the amount of silver?
Be quick! Fire!
Beat them, beat!
Skull and Bones just revealed new gameplay and is bringing you all that good pirate action on the Indian Ocean when it launches on November 8th. But we know why you're here. You want to know more about your ships and blowing stuff up. Well, to learn more about your fleet and combat so you can blow stuff up.
It's the first ship that you get when you start the game as you're rescued by what will eventually become your crew. It's what we call kind of the hunter-gatherer ship, where you learn how to gather resources and hunt some of the wildlife to basically collect things that you'll need to use to craft bigger and better ships, different weapons, and different armors.
In the early hours, will players have the tools to start fights with other ships, or is it your boat situation?
If you choose to join a PvP, you can engage with combat with other players at any time. So you'll be upgrading your ships pretty quickly in the game to get something larger where you can start adding cannons, some more firepower. Here's if you wish, it's a little bit easier to sink them and try to steal their loot.
As players craft newer and bigger ships, what relationship will they have with their fleet? Do you envision players having one flagship that pour all of their resources into upgrading?
At launch, we have 12 playable ships, which we call the captain's fleet, that we want the players to eventually acquire, unlock, and craft. And we definitely are more in the second camp of that question, where we want the ships to have things that they're best at. We call them kind of tools that's all you use for the rest of the game. You know, I'm sure players will get an affinity for the certain types of play styles and ships that they like the most for taking on certain types of activities and certain type of pirating in the game. If you were given a contract or a job from another pirate to move a large quantity of, you know, stolen goods or dangerous material from one place to another, as one of our like quests in the game. So you can use anything for most activities in the game, but there will always be the best choice for what you're trying to accomplish. We wanted to be best in class for this type of game, which is, you know, ships on the sea. So our combat is very fast paced, and we also have depth added into the combat. So the types of weapons you choose versus your enemies will be important. As you're in combat, your crew actually kind of works into this combat fervor, which we call fury, and you'll be able to unleash what we call crew-to-crew attacks. That could turn into a boarding attack, and it's the only way you can actually get all the loot and make sure that nothing sinks to the bottom. All of our weapons and armors are classified into an element. So it's based on, you know, of course we want to be grounded in reality of this 17th century kind of dawn of piracy. So things will be blunt, or maybe they will cause tearing of the sails, or they could cause flooding. Now, based on the target that you're taking on, they'll have some type of armor. It could be just wood. It might be stone, it might be clay, which we call terracotta in the armor section. And based on your loadout, you will have either a good effect, you know, you'll have a bonus damage to that enemy type, or you might be neutral to that enemy type, or you might actually be doing less damage. Now, you're never completely inefficient. You can always take on any target with any type of loadout, but there will be better, more effective loadouts depending on what you're facing. Also, the sails are a way that you can actually slow your enemies or eventually kind of rooting them in place for a temporary period of time where they can be easier to take out. Also, all of our enemy ships have something we call weak points. So it might be more difficult to escape a player, for instance, who's chasing you, but you definitely can flee. And we have safe areas around both dens in the game, which are kind of our mini pirate villages, if you will. So you can run and flee to get back to those areas, and then you'll be safe. Or you can just try to outrun or outsail some of the enemies if they're chasing you, which also can happen. in some of our plundering activities, the whole point might be just to kind of snatch and grab. So you get what you can while you can hold off the enemy, the reinforcements coming, and then you were always planning on running at some point. So that's definitely possible.
As a follow-up question, if combat really doesn't go your way, what happens to your ship and crew when you're sunk? What happens to your cargo?
So if you do happen to get sunk, which will happen to everyone, of your materials, then you'll respawn basically either at one of the dens or at the nearest outpost, depending on what you choose. And most of your, if you choose to then go sail out to your wreck and no one has looted it, like another player, then you will basically get all of your materials back, and it'll just have cost you a little bit of time, and you recraft your ship and you keep going.
With this wind, nothing can catch us!
You know, Skull and Bones is an online open world or open sea game, and so you definitely will be coming across other players. And whether or not PvP can be an option is based on your choice. So are you on a PvP opt-in server or not? So if you are, then you have to be kind of wary and make sure that you're not going to become the target of another pirate. But at any point, if you feel like, you know, that's not for you, or you feel like there's maybe too many players that are engaging in PvP on the server you're on, you can just opt out immediately and go to a PvE-only server. And then maybe you progress a little further, you get a different ship, you upgrade some of your weapons, and maybe you want to jump back into a PvP-enabled server. Because there are benefits for playing and risking more on the PvP-enabled servers.
Well, I think I'm ready for combat.
Bones. Our game takes place during the golden age of piracy, in a world inspired by the beautiful yet dangerous Indian Ocean. You'll start your journey as an outcast whose goal is to become the most infamous pirate to sail these treacherous waters. After surviving a shipwreck, you begin your adventure in St. Anne, one of the pirate dens in our world. Dens are centers of pirate activity where you can craft new ships and equipment, provision for your expeditions at sea, pick up contracts, and socialize with other players. Any pirate worth their salt will tell you that preparation is key to success. Get ready for any challenges that come your way by checking that your cargo is stocked with items like food and ammunition. Once you're set, it's time to head out and explore. As a rookie pirate, you'll only have access to a small dhow. But as you progress, you'll be able to craft different ships, each with their own unique playstyle. At sea, you'll need to pay close attention to the condition of your ship and the morale of your crew. Your crew are a pack of vicious raiders and rovers who will mutiny against you if not kept well-fed and happy. If your ship sinks, you'll lose some progress and respawn at the nearest discovered den or outpost. The good news is that most of your cargo will be recovered, and you'll have the opportunity to retrieve the rest from the wreckage. But you'd better be quick, as other players can also steal it. As a pirate captain, your reputation is everything, and our game tracks this through infamy. The higher your infamy, the more opportunities you'll get. One of the many ways to grow your infamy is to take up contracts. These are deals that you can make with other pirates in the world. Contracts can have great rewards if you're successful, or costs if you fail. You can also gain infamy by completing other activities, such as exploration, plundering, treasure hunts, investigations, dynamic events, and much more. You can undertake these either solo or with other players. The world of Skull and Bones is filled with riches and resources that you'll be able to gather as you explore. Lagoons and rivers are teeming with dangerous wildlife that you can hunt for animal skins and meat. You'll also be able to harvest a variety of raw materials, such as ore and wood, that can be refined and used for crafting. Crafting is an essential activity for you to progress as an infamous pirate. Obtain blueprints and use your refined resources to craft stronger ships, weapons, and armors. In Skull and Bones, ships serve many different purposes. Cargo ships are slower, but useful if you need to transport large volumes of loot. Navigation ships sail faster, but have less cargo space and lower hull HP. Firepower ships have more gun ports, allowing you to deal higher damage, but are more challenging to maneuver. Similarly, you can craft a wide array of unique weapons and armors, from Greek fires to giant ballistae to rocket launchers and mortars, as well as different armor types, which have varying strengths and weaknesses against incoming attacks. With your new fleet and growing arsenal, create a loadout based on your personal playstyle to become a force of destruction. Out in the open ocean, opportunities and threats are abundant. Use your spyglass to identify lucrative trade routes or wealthy merchant ships and assess your prey's cargo and firepower. Strategize a plan of attack based on your opponent's defenses and take advantage of their weak points to deal more damage. Sinking your foes from afar rewards you with only a portion of their cargo, as some of it will be lost to the depths. Getting in close to execute a boarding maneuver will help maximize your gains. But beware, you can turn from predator to prey in a heartbeat if you attract the unwanted attention of privateers, the merciless pirate hunters that patrol the seas. If you enjoy the thrill of the hunt, you can also seek out other players and rain terror on them. Such PvP battles are high-stakes activities that can be rewarding if you emerge victorious. From your spoils of battle, personalize your individual look with outfits that command respect. You can also select from a multitude of ship customization options to instill fear in your enemies. With the wind in your sails, journey to the furthest reaches of the Indian Ocean, from the coast of Africa to the East Indies. Encounter extreme weather events like violent storms and monstrous rogue waves. Keep your eyes peeled for outposts, which are safe spots where you'll be able to dock your ship for a short rest from the perilous seas. Here, you can trade with traveling merchants and clandestine smugglers selling rare and illegal goods. Uncover buried bounties at outposts as you decipher treasure maps obtained through your voyages. Although all the content in Skull and Bones can be done solo, you might enjoy ruling the seas with your friends. While sailing, you can also easily invite other pirates you encounter to group up. Synergize your different playstyles, ships, and weapons to defeat deadlier enemies. As you grow stronger, take on more difficult challenges, such as attacking forts and plundering settlements. And, if you're bold enough, engage in dynamic events, like taking down heavily laden merchant ships and their fleet of warship escorts. Now, it's up to you to write your own story. Remember, there is no one path to follow, no one way to play. The world of Skull and Bones is yours.